हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी वार्म गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक इन अवर बायोलॉजी सेशन. सो इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द 8th शेड्यूल एंड इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट फ्रॉम 7th स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट बोर्ड. ओके, इन दैट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द फेमाइन एंड नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट नेचुरल डिजास्टर दैट इज वॉट क्लाउड बर्स्ट. ओके, so let's discuss about the cloudburst. Before that, as you know, what causes the rain? As you know, the water resources are there. In that, what happened? Because of the heat of the sun, the waters get evaporate. It goes up very high and it gets cooled down. Okay, that is what evaporation. After that, condensation happens and which causes the clouds. Okay, and when that drops get collected to each other, started to get together, comes together, then it becomes heavier and it started to fall down in the form of rain. In this form, the rain happens. Okay, but in the certain times or in the sometimes what happens, sometimes the water coming down from the rain clouds does not reach the land in the form of rain. Instead, due to very high temperature near the land, it evaporates and goes back into the same cloud. Okay, so what happened exactly? See here, as we know, because of the heat of the sun, here I can show you the raindrops comes down, okay, but it doesn't reaches on the surface of the land. Okay, and due to the high temperature from the middle, it get evaporates and again goes back into the same cloud. Okay, means from the same cloud it comes down, but the heat is more, that's why it get evaporates from the middle only and again goes back into the same cloud. Because of that, what happened? As a result, the amount of water vapor in these clouds become very high, and because of that, what happened? The amount of the water vapor or the evaporation, it get increases. That's why the water vapors get increases in that same clouds, and that clouds become so much high or very high. Due to rapid condensation, it rains suddenly over a specific and a small region at a rate of 100 millimeter per hour or more. Okay, so because of that, what happened? Due to the rapid condensation, the water vapors get converted into the water, and that speed is very high, and because of that, what happened? It rains suddenly. Okay, it rains very suddenly, but in a very small region or over a specific and small region. Okay, and the rate of that waterfall or the rainfall is what? 100 millimeter per hour or more than that. And that situation is called as what? Cloud burst. Okay, that called as what? Cloud burst. Okay, so let's see when it does happen, that cloud burst. The cloud burst occurred at Leh Ladakh on 6 October 2010. Okay, 2010. The cloudburst that occurred in Mumbai on 26th August 2005 was extraordinary and unforgettable. Okay, so as we know, in the Mumbai also on the 26th August 2005, in the year of 2005, there was a heavy rainfall, and that extraordinary or that situation was unforgettable. On that day, it rained about, on the 26th August 2005, that day the rain about 950 millimeter. Okay, that is 37 inches in 8 to 10 hours. So within 8 to 10 hours, the rain was 37 inches. That is what, if we talk about in the millimeter, then it was 950 millimeter. And the entire city of Mumbai was waterlogged and flooded. Okay, so there, that was happens on the in the Mumbai. Now let's discuss the next one, that is what? Flood. Okay, so let's see what is mean by flood. As we know, if there is a high rainfall with for a some time or for the long period of the time and with the same quantity, then it causes what? Flood. We have already learned about the flood and the effects of the flood. Collect the information about the flood that have occurred at various places in Maharashtra in the last few years. Okay, so flood means what? It is the situation. During that situation, what happened? The heavy rainfall is there for the long period of the time. Okay, continuous rainfall is there and very high rainfall is there, which causes what? Flood. So there are the certain protective measures that we will see. Protective measures in a view of floods. First one, construction of small dams in mountains regions. Okay, construction of small dams in the mountains regions. So as we know, in the mountain regions there is a high amount of the rainfall. So to protect the flood, we have to construct the small dams on the mountain region. Next one, construction of percolation tanks. Now percolation tanks means what? We have to allow the more and more water to percolate into the soil, to goes into the soil. Like that we have to make the tanks. That tanks are called as what? Percolation tanks. Making river beds flat. Okay, on the rivers we have to make the river banks or beds. Cultivation of new forest. We have to cultivate the new forest. If the trees will be more, than the trees can, or that roots can absorb the more and more water, we can say that. Connecting rivers, we have to connect the rivers to each other, so it will happens to distribute that flood water. Okay, so this is the next natural famine, natural or disaster, that is what? Flood. Now we'll discuss about the lightning. This lightning already we have discussed in the physics point. So the you have learned about the generation of electric charges and lightning strike in the lesson on static electricity. In this lesson we shall learn something more about the lightning and the measure for protection. So how it causes the lightning, that you have already discussed in your physics. Now we will discuss how, which precautions we have to take during the lightning. Wonderful thing to know, lightning temperature more intense than the sun. Okay, so as we know, the sun is the ultimate source of energy on the earth, but as we compare the energy from the sun and the energy which takes place or happens during the lightning, then the lightning temperature is more intense than the sun. Okay, so let's see. Not all lightning strikes the ground. In fact, about 95% of the lightning flashes are limited on the sky. Okay, so not all the lightning reach to the ground, but about 95% of the lightning flash are limited on the sky. So the 95% of the lightning or the flash are takes place in the sky. Next one, only 5% of the lightning reaches the ground, and among that 95% limited in the sky, and only the 5% of the lightning reaches to the ground. Lightning can be generated within one cloud, so it can be takes place in a one cloud, between two clouds, or between a cloud and the ground. Okay, so these are the three possibilities which are responsible for the lightning. First one, we can say lightning can be generated within a one cloud, between two clouds, or between the cloud and the ground. About 40 lightning flashes occur per second. Very important sentence, that is what? Within a second, about 40 lightning flash means about 40 flashes takes place within a 1 second in the atmosphere. The temperature generated by lightning is higher than that of the sun. So during the lightning, the temperature generated is more than the temperature of the sun. Due to this high temperature, the air under high pressure expands suddenly and a loud crashing sound is heard. Okay, so how it causes the more sound? Due to this high temperature, so as we know that lightning generated the high temperature more than the sun. So due to this high temperature, the air under the high pressure expands. So as we know, air expands on heating. So because of that heat, the air under high pressure expands suddenly and a loud crashing sound is heard. Okay, so this is about what? Lightning. Now let's see where the exactly lightning strike. Lightning strikes open ground maximum times. The worst mortality rate due to lightning is low. Mortality means the death rate. Okay, so however, the survivors of lightning strike suffer long-term effects. Immediate treatment of the lightning affected person can save their life. Okay, so if we'll talk about the mortality rate due to the lightning is low, but still if anyone get affected due to the lightning, then that person should get the treatment as early as possible to save their life. A study of places struck with lightning shows that it happens more on the open ground than under a tree or near water. So the mostly the lightning is takes place in the open land. Okay, next one. Mishaps have occurred most often when a person is at a high place or near a tall object. Okay, and it will fall mostly if the person is standing at a high place or near a tall tree. Okay, mostly it strikes on the tall places or the high places. Okay, now next one we'll discuss that what precautions will you take during thunderstorm. Okay, so if there is a thunderstorm, then which type of precautions we have to take? Do not stand on open ground or below a tree. Means if there is a thunderstorm, then do not stand on open ground or below the tree. Do not go to a high location or climb a tree. Do not stand near an electric pole, telephone pole or a tower, etc. Do not lean on wire fences around a farm, a compound, a garden or a house. Okay, means do not, if you are having the fencing, then it should be not made up of the wire. Okay, do not lean on the wire fences around a farm. If you are on a two-wheelers, a bicycle, a tractor or a boat, get off immediately and go to a safe place. If you are driving something, if you are driving any vehicle, then you should get off immediately from that and go to a safe place. Do not gather all together in one place. Very important. Take care to keep a distance of 15 feet between any two person. There should be the 15 feet distance between the two persons. Do not use plugged or electrical appliances. Do not use mobile or telephone. Stand on a dry wood, a plastic sheet, sack or a jute cloth or a dry leaves. Okay, it is very important. Why is it like that? So stand on a dry wood, a plastic sheet, sack or a jute cloth or a dry leaves. Okay, next one, keeping your feet together, support yourself on the soles of your feet, placing your hands on your knees and crouch low. Okay, means like that we have seen him, keeping your feet together, support yourself on the soles. As you know, see, I'll show you in the image how exactly you have to see during the thunderstorm. Swimmer or fisherman should immediately come out of the water. A pukka house is the safest place. Okay, find out if there is a lightning conductor or any tall building near your house. If necessary, get a lightning conductor fitted on your house. Okay, so if the house is a pukka house, then it is safest place. And if there is a lightning conductor or on any building near your house, if necessary, get a lightning conductor fitted on your house. Okay, so these are the certain precautions that we have to take during the thunderstorm. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.